So you have to find the magnitude of resultant vector of two vectors, vector A and vector B acting at an angle theta, that is r equal to root over a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta, and using parallelogram law of vector addition. And also you have to find the direction of the resultant vector. So in this diagram, OPSQ be the parallelogram drawn at the point O, two vectors, vector A and vector B, are acting at the point O, and they are represented in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides OP and OQ. In that case, the resultant vector, vector R is represented, in magnitude and direction, magnitude and direction by the diagonal, which diagonal? This diagonal, OS. So this is the resultant vector. Resultant vector is the diagonal OS, represented in magnitude and direction by the diagonal OS of the parallelogram drawn from the same point O. In this case, vector A and vector B have the directions from O to P and O to Q, and they are represented by this arrows at the end of this straight line, and this diagonal is the resultant vector. So therefore you can say that vector R is the resultant of two vectors A and B, and in this case theta be the angle between that two vectors. Angle between vector A and vector B is theta, the total angle theta. And what we can write, so the straight line OP is equivalent to magnitude of vector A is equivalent to A. That means OP is equal to magnitude of this vector, and OQ is equal to magnitude of the second vector is equal to B. And a perpendicular SN is drawn from which point? From the point S on the side OP extended in forward direction. So that's why SN is a perpendicular, and this is 90 degree. So if we move to the next page, then from the right angle triangle SNO, what is the length of the diagonal OS? Length of the diagonal OS is root over base square ON square plus SN square. ON square plus SN square. And is equal to, and in place of ON, what we can write? OP plus PN. OP plus PN whole square plus SN square. Now if we apply the formula OP square plus 2OP dot pn plus pn square plus sn square. So root over op square plus 2 op dot pn, and in place of pn square plus sn square, what we can write? PS square. Since we know that PS is equal to root over PN square plus SN square. So now what we can write? OP square plus PS square plus 2OP dot PN. We get this. This is equation 1. Now OP is equal to A, PS is equal to B, and what about PN? PN is the base, which is hypotenuse PS into cos theta. If we so therefore what we can say, PN is equal to B cos theta. So if we return to the diagram, so PN is the base, and this angle will be again theta. So base PN is equal to hypotenuse PS into cos theta. That's why PN is equal to B cos theta, because PS is equal to, is parallel and have the same magnitude as that of OQ. So PS is equal to B, or magnitude of B, and PN is equal to B cos theta. And what about OS? OS is magnitude of mod vector R, or R only. So therefore we can say OS is equal to root over A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So OS means only R, or magnitude of resultant vector R. So we get finally root over A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So this is what R. R is equal to root over A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. And so therefore it can be written as what? Magnitude of vector R will be equal to root over magnitude of vector A square plus magnitude of vector B square plus 2 mod vector A mod vector B cos theta. So this is the formula of, or this is the magnitude of resultant vector of two vectors. This is magnitude of resultant vector R, magnitude of resultant vector R, resultant vector R of two vectors, vector A and vector B, two vectors A and vector B acting at an angle theta, at an angle theta, acting at an angle theta, that is the magnitude. Now if we find the magnitude direction, so so if we erase this part, to find the direction of resultant vector, direction of resultant vector, we get the magnitude, then direction of, how to find the direction of vector R, resultant vector. Let vector R acts at an angle theta with vector A. From triangle
right angle triangle SNO. If we return to the diagram, here which angle is phi, that is you have to know. So this angle is phi. This angle is phi. So vector r acts at an angle phi with this vector a. And here, from triangle SNO, what about tan phi? Tan phi is equal to perpendicular by base. SN by base is ON. Since SN is equal to perpendicular is equal to hypotenuse PS cos theta. So here we can write PS cos, not cos theta, perpendicular is equal to hypotenuse into sin theta. PS sin theta. And here what we can write, PS is the side sin theta. And ON is what, OP plus PN. Now PS is what? PS is equivalent to B. B sin theta divided by A plus B cos theta. So this is the formula of tangent of phi, and here phi is that angle. Therefore, phi is equal to tan inverse B sin theta divided by A plus B cos theta. This is the angle at which the resultant vector acts at an angle, resultant vector acts with the vector A. Hence, what we can write, vector R means resultant vector acts at an angle, at an angle phi is equal to tan inverse B sin theta divided by A plus B cos theta. With which vector? With the vector, with vector A. That is the direction. Here phi is the direction with respect to vector A. Here vector R acts at an angle vector, phi with vector A. So phi is the direction of the resultant vector R.